If you're new to Linux, then you might have heard of the terminal. A terminal is the really cool way to interact with your computer in like a hackery way. Not exactly hackery, but it feels like it in some cases. So the terminal is where you run commands and you can build scripts and stuff and run them in there. First and foremost, you do not need to use the terminal. If you don't want to use it, you don't have to. You can just use the GUI stuff and run it through apps and click buttons and all that. Totally fine. You don't have to do this stuff. Now, with that said, let's talk about using the terminal and getting started with it, because you can go as far as you want. You can get into the super complicated stuff if you want to. But we're going to start you off with some essential Linux commands. In fact, 5 essential Linux commands every beginner needs to know. Well, you don't need to know, because like I said, you don't have to use a terminal. But if you want to learn how to interact with a terminal, these are fundamental commands. So let's jump into it. So the first command is ls, which is basically a functionality to list files inside of your system, files and directories. So if you just type in ls in your command line or terminal, you will see various files, whatever folder you're in. So if you just type ls, it'll show you all the visible files and folders. Now, if you want to type ls-l, this will display more information, basically detailed info, including the size of the file, the date it was created, permissions, and so on. And then if you want to do more, you can do ls-a, and that will show you the visible and invisible items, so the hidden items like .dot files or .dot config files and stuff like that. So basically, a hidden file in Linux is one that starts with a dot. So if you have any file that you don't want to see for your home folder for some reason, you can just push, rename it, and then hit put a dot in the beginning of it, and then it will hide it. And you can use Control H to unhide it if you want to later to, well, actually reveal all of them in the file manager, or you can do ls-a to do that. And also you can combine them by doing ls-la and having a detailed view of all the files and folders, including the hidden ones. Now, that's going to only work on your home folder, because that's the default folder you're in when you go into a terminal. But you can move around and run the ls command on other folders by using the cd command, which means change directories. So you can go into a subfolder. Let's say, for example, you want to go into your documents folder and look for files there. You just type in cd space and then the name of the folder, like documents. Once you're in there, you could then use ls and see all the files inside of that folder. Now, if you are in a terminal and you want to go back up a directory, so if you're in the documents folder and want to go back up to your home folder, then you do cd space period period or dot dot, and that will go up a directory. Now, this works regardless of what directory you're in. So if you have multiple directories inside of your system and you have, for example, 2 or 3 subfolders inside of documents, then doing cd dot dot will go up one folder depending on which one you're in. So if you have, say, for example, you are in documents and then subfolder 1 and then another subfolder 2 inside of that, then if you do cd dot dot, it will take you to subfolder 1, provided you are already in 2. So if you do cd documents slash subfolder 1 slash subfolder 2, that will put you inside of the subfolder 2 folder. And then when you do cd dot dot, that will bring you right back up to subfolder 1. And then cd dot dot again will do the documents folder. However, as a bonus, if you want to put in more dots, that will make it jumping up different folders. So if you have cd'd into your documents slash subfolder 1 slash subfolder 2, and you are in that subfolder 2 inside of your terminal, you can do cd dot dot dot, and that will put you back up to documents. So you skip the first folder. And you can do as many as you want, depending on how many folders you're in. But if you want to just go back to your home directory, regardless of what folder you're in or subfolder you're in, there's a different command that makes that much faster. So the cd tilde key is the command to run. And if you don't know what tilde means, that's the wavy thing. That will take you to your home directory. And this also will apply to basically any time you want to reference your home folder. You can just use that symbol inside of the terminal and it will know what you mean. And the last one I want to show you about cd is that you can do cd space dash, And that will basically do a previous directory type of movement. So if you go up to the documents folder in the last comparison, and you do CD dash, and then that will take you back to subfolder 2. So that's basically what it does. So this is a pretty useful command to do navigation for files. But what if you want to copy some files into another folder? Well, you can use the CP command. And then, for example, you have notes.txt, and you want to make a backup, you can just do notes.txt space notes underscore backup.txt and make a copy of it, but also have a renaming version so you have a backup of your file. Now, of course, that's going to put them in the same folder. So if you wanted to, you can actually change that and say, I want to put it in a different folder, a different subfolder of my home. So remember when I talked about the tilde key being the home folder and will be usable in various different commands? Well, we're going to use it again. So cp space photo.jpg space tilde key slash pictures slash vacation. This would then make a copy of the photo.jpg file into that particular folder. It's also possible to use the cp command to copy entire folders, including the files inside of it. So if you wanted to do that, you do cp space dash r, which is basically recursive, which means you're saying use everything that's inside of this folder. So move the folder and everything in it, including subfolders if there are some. So then you would say after the dash r, you'd have project, and then you'd put it wherever you want, like tilde slash documents slash backup. Next, we have the rm command. So this is actually to remove files. Now, this is something that you should only use when you know what to do with it, because there are sometimes people are not the nicest online sometimes, and they will send you a specific command that includes this, and you should never run it because it's always bad. And that is sudo rm-rf slash. What that means is that it's going to delete your entire system. It's basically a alt F4 for your whole computer. So don't do that. So rm is the remove command, and it can be useful. For example, if you have a file, let's say, for some reason you have a file called outdated underscore notes. So you would do rm space outdated underscore notes.txt, and it would delete the file for you. You can also do this with multiple files at the same time. For example, you could do rm, then space file1.txt, space file2.txt, space file3.txt, and it will delete all of those files at once. Next, this is a different command, but still part of the rm command, and it's rmdir or rmdir, and this you can then delete empty folders. So you put the name of the folder after this command. Now, what if you want to delete a folder and that's not empty, and you want to delete the folder and all of the contents? Well, you would do rm space dash R, remember that's the recursive, which means it will remove everything inside that folder as well as the folder itself. And then you'd put like, you know, old project folder name, and then it would delete that and everything in it. And next we have rm dash I important underscore doc.txt. Now, the thing that this does is basically just asks you for confirmation before deleting the file. So it's actually recommended to put dash I and everything. So before it does the action, it will tell you or ask you a question if you really want to do this. And that way you give yourself a little bit of time before you delete something. Now, it might be a little bit of wasting time depending on how often you do this, but it is nice to have a peace of mind to just be asked. And maybe you're like, oh, I don't really want to delete this yet. That's why you just add it, just in case. And now we have sudo. Sudo will execute commands with root slash admin privileges. So for example, if you want to install your a package that you get from the repository, you do sudo apt install, then the name of the package. Or if you're using Fedora, you would do sudo dnf install, then the name of the package. And then also et cetera for the other distributions. Another one example that you would probably use quite often if you are trying to learn the terminal and you want to administer your system through the terminal, that would be for Ubuntu and Ubuntu-based users, as well as Debian users, of course, would be sudo apt update and then followed by sudo apt upgrade. Now, you can put them in the same command by putting ampersands in between those two commands. So if you were to just put sudo apt update and then run it and then run sudo apt upgrade, it would work, But if you wanted to save a little bit of time, you could do sudo apt update ampersand ampersand and then sudo apt upgrade back to back. So when you push enter, it will do both of them in sequence. Now, the next thing you might want to do is you want to edit a file that has administration protection. So if you have a protected system file that you want to change a config file, for example, that's in one of the Etsy folders, then you would do sudo nano and then the path to the file. So this would allow you to use a terminal editor, which is called nano, and give yourself administrative privileges to do the edits. And that way you could just do it right there and then save out. We'll talk about nano in the future if you want, but sudo is the way to elevate your access on a temporary basis. It's not meant to be always having that power, because you don't really want to always have that power, because you could accidentally overwrite things or change things you don't want to and that sort of stuff. So it's just better to have it when you need it. And this next one could be really useful if you are having some kind of system failure, system malfunction, and you want to reboot your system. Well, you might not be able to go into the terminal if there's something really bad, but you would do this in the terminal. But if there is something going really bad, you would do a Control Alt F1 or F2 or F3 or whatever. It doesn't really matter. And that will take you to what is called a TTY. And that's basically a terminal access outside of the system itself, outside of the desktop, outside of the display server and all of that. So it's just the terminal. And in here, you could put sudo space reboot to quickly reboot your system. And this way, you can put in your password and be able to easily reboot if you have no other option. But you don't want that to be a thing. It's just in case. And if you want to just shut your system down, you could do sudo shutdown now, which tells you to do it immediately. So it's telling the system now. You can also say, I want to shut down in 5 minutes or whatever. You can control that if you want to. But these are really helpful if you're having any kind of issue, or you just want to quickly shut your system down and you don't want to do it through the system, the UI system, the GUI system, because it actually is faster sometimes to just shut your system down this way. Because if you already have a terminal open, or you have something like KRunner in KDE Plasma or whatever, you can just run commands that way. And it's pretty nice. Maybe not the most practical use case of it, of sudo, but it still would come handy in some cases. So there you have it. That is 5 Linux commands that are essential for you to start getting started with the terminal. And also be sure to subscribe, because another video just like this is coming out pretty soon with more commands that will help you get more situated with the terminal if you want to do it. But again, reminder, you don't have to use a terminal if you don't want to. But if you want to, subscribe, because there'll be more tips. Actually, subscribe anyway, because there're gonna be more videos that are not necessarily terminal related, because I like to make a lot of videos. So feel free to subscribe. There's a lot more coming. And also, if you would like some more content right now, well, you can check out the latest episode of This Week in Linux, which is right here. And this is a great show that I make. So go check it out. And also, you can check out whatever this video is that YouTube says is the best fit for the viewer. I'm not sure what it is, but probably great, because I made it and I'm not biased at all. So go check it out.